section this top part off for now. Good rule of thumb is that you want to separate, when you do your perimeter, if you separate it in half, then you want to do four sections when you use your blending shears. If you do three, then you want to do six. You want to double it.
Could you repeat that? If you do four, three.
So I separated this back section into two to do my perimeter. So now I'm going to do four horizontal sections.
Okay.
So if you did three, then you'd want to do six.
Okay.
Just for control of the hair. So I'm going to take my blending shears. You don't want anything with like really extreme teeth on it. Something that's pretty normal, fine, blendy.
A regular
blending shear. Okay, so for comfort, I'm tilting her head forward, but that means that I have to be aware of my shear and my suctioning. So I'm gonna hold this. I'm sorry.
Comfort for you.
Comfort for me, so yes. Because if she's up like this, then I have to be up here and it's just not comfortable.
If this was a real human, would you have her look down?
Yes.
Okay.
If it was a real human, I would have her look down. Now, I'm going to do approximately five vertical sections. If you can control three, then do three. But the texture will change, right? You will have less texture with larger sections than you will with smaller sections. So keep that in mind. So I'm gonna hold this at 90 degrees. Once I get my fingers out to the perimeter, I am going to bring my finger angle in to a 45. Then I'm going to take my blending shears and just take that corner off. Okay? I'm going to repeat that on all of these subsections, slightly over-directing towards the center. Just taking that corner off. Now, I want it to be jagged. I don't want it to be perfect. I don't want to take the whole corner off either, because when that lands back down, I want it to be soft and I want there to be movement, but I still like that almost one length feel. That's what people are wearing in bobs today. So you want it to be modern. Now this corner, you want to make sure that you let that corner drop out so you don't cut a hole, and just take that corner off. So I'm going to repeat that on the next two subsections, and then the next three horizontal sections, everything coming out at 90, taking my finger angle in at 45. The only difference is that you're taking each of these sections individually. So this section, here, I'll show you. All right, I get it. You're visual people, I get it. So I'm gonna take.
So you're doing five sections up the back?
I'm doing four.
Four.
Five vertical sections.
Gotcha.
Up to the top of the head where my sections are. Okay, so I've already cut the bottom section. So now I'm holding this section out. See, my bottom section is right there, but what I want to do is go to the end of this section and then tilt my fingers in, okay? Now, we've already done a haircut on this, so there might be places where you don't have a lot of hair to cut, but you've got to go through the motions, okay? So don't use the section previous underneath as your guide. You're going to use each section individually for your guide of the bottom.
Are you using a traveling guide or no?
Your guide of your section.
Your guide changes with each section.
Yeah.
So it's not really traveling, it's going to move with each section. Does that make sense?
Yeah.
Okay, perfect. Can everybody go do this?
Yeah.
Great.